हेलो चिल्ड्रन, वेलकम टू द स्टैंडर्ड 6 सोशल साइंस क्लास। डियर चिल्ड्रन, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू चैप्टर 7। ऑल ऑफ यू ओपन पेज नंबर 59। एमर्जेंस ऑफ न्यू आइडियाज एंड रिलीजियंस, बुद्धिज्म एंड जैनिज्म। सी चिल्ड्रन, Around 6th century BC, two great men were born. They were Gautama Buddha and Vardhamana Mahavira. They gave birth to two religions, Buddhism and Jainism. The period of 600 BCE to 400 BCE So, a lot of things common in the Indian subcontinent in the political, social, religious and cultural life. The study of Upanishads, Jainism and Buddhism will give us a glimpse of new ideas and movements. Dear students, what is the meaning of glimpse? Glimpse means a momentary or partial view. Now we will see Upanishads. The word Upanishada is a combination of three syllables, Upa, Ni and Sad. Here Upa means near, Ni means down and Sad means to sit. In this way, Upanishada means to sit at the feet of the Guru to receive his teachings. The Upanishads are the last books of the Vedic literature. They are also called the Vedanta. There are approximately 108 non-Upanishads. While some were composed around 600 BCE, Other were composed later. See students, Upanishadic teacher and students. Ideas in the Upanishads. In the Upanishads, thinkers unveiled the mysteries of life. Here, students, unveiled means remove a veil. They wanted to know about the life after death. Upanishads thinkers wanted to know why sacrifices should be performed. According to Vedas, even after the body dies, the soul or Atman cannot be set free. It is said to reborn in another form. On the other side, Upanishads believe that the Atman can become free after death by uniting with the Brahman, which is a universal soul. So this idea was quite different from the Vedic beliefs. The Upanishads deal with the Indian philosophy and evolved the theories of karma, maya and mukti. According to these theories, the actions of karma in one's life shall bear their fruit in the next life. The individual soul itself is immortal, but it is involved. Children, turn the page. Now we are on page number 60. In an unending cycle of births and rebirths, a human being continues to be reborn in this world until he attains moksha or freedom from the cycle of rebirth by doing the right karmas. They believed that there were three methods to achieve moksha. What are they? See, These are three methods. 1. The karma marg or the way of good deeds. 2. The gyan marg or the way of true knowledge. And 3. The bhakti marg or the way of divine devotion. Thus, Upanishads contain many different ideas joined together loosely. The Upanishads discuss about creation of the world, creations of man, the practice of yoga, meditation, karma, and truths about life and death. The Upanishads give importance to the worship of one God. They discuss how the Atman can be united with the universal soul. Children, do you know? Shankaracharya was a great exponent of the Upanishads. He propounded the theory of Advaita. Students, exponents means a person who supports an idea or theory and tries to persuade people of its truth or benefits. Now we will see causes of the origin of new religious ideas and faith. Firstly, the Vedic religion was a religion of many rituals and sacrifices. People wanted to be more mortal, dedicated and pure. Therefore, they worshipped to a religion which was easy to understand and follow. Second, rigid caste-based society was the main cause of the origin of new religion. The high caste Hindus developed hatred for the low caste people. So, these people wanted to adopt such a religion in which they were accepted. 3. Number. At the same time, people felt that it was very difficult to follow the Vedic religion. And 4. All the religious texts were in Sanskrit language, which the common people could not understand. The above circumstances were thus best suited for the origin and growth of new religions. Initially, more than 60 religious groups emerged in North India. Among these sects, Jainism and Buddhism evolved as the most popular religions. Okay, students, thank you.